Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back in the laboratory with a little bench talk. I've been watching your videos, and in particular Dave Parker. I've been watching your 12 days of airbrushing Christmas or something like that, and I have to say I'm enjoying the heck out of it. You are in fact making progress, and I just wanted to talk a little bit about what, you know, your approach. I've been using this baby right here, which I just finished cleaning, and so I, you know, I'm showing it to you because it's like it's a brand new. I cleaned it. I reamed it out with my little micro brushes. I have a whole bunch of these little micro brushes that help keep my airbrushes clean. And when you're using enamels, testers enamels, you know, you're using cheap, lukewarm, that's what Don Yost calls it, lukewarm, I just call it cold lacquer, meaning that it's not hot lacquer, like automotive lacquer, because that's going to destroy your work. Your plastic's going to go to, you know, it's just going to get crazed and ruin your paint job. But this is the beauty of this system. The Don Yost system is that, you know, using cold or lukewarm lacquer, garden variety, that's what he calls it, you could get a lot of mileage out of it, and your enamel ends up drying a lot faster. Now, this setup is done so that you make a smooth transition from rattle canning to the airbrush, you know. I don't have a rattle, yeah, I do, but I mean, I'm going to use whatever is near here. Let's just say this is a can of paint, you know, and so you just go back and forth. You go turning the model, and you go back and forth, always passing the edges of your model, you know, and what you're trying to do is you're trying to mist coats on there until, you know, 14, up to 12, 14 coats later, your color and your gloss starts to catch on fire, you know, and then you see it. The same thing with the airbrush, you know, the airbrush, in particular this baby, you know, you just hold it, and you know, you'll see me do this because it's kind of stop and go. It's single action, you know. If you keep it pressed, it's going to keep spitting paint on your model. So it's, you know, pass the panel, stop, press again, pass the panel, and it's back and forth. So it's very close to the stroke you get used to using with rattle cans. You know, later on you evolve into a dual action airbrush, where you can in fact use the trigger to just blow air on your model and dry it that much faster, especially if you're doing template work. But that's, you know, that's neither here nor there right now. We're talking about doing single color paint jobs using the Pache H. I use the five, the widest needle, and I use it at the widest setting. You know, you adjust it here, and you go, you know, you go testing it, and again, test it on plastic spoons. I told Dave that I said, you know, I'm surprised you haven't been sleeping with your airbrush under the bed, which was kind of a joke, but I was also being serious. You know, you have to live with the thing. Carry it around with you. I mean, carry it without the bottle, obviously, right? And then just, you know, keep it in your pocket, and every once in a while, just pretend that you are, you know, doing your stroke until you start getting it right, and you'll start getting some wonderful results with your paint job. Now, I'm a big fan and a big supporter of Don Yost. He's been nothing but kind to me. He's actually a wonderful friend. you know, we talk almost on a daily basis. We exchange texts. He shows me what he's working on. I show him what I'm working on. And so I want to support his efforts. It's taken him a lot of years to get to the level he's at. And so I have nothing but the utmost respect and admiration for the man and for the man as a builder. So, you know, support his not only his website, but also if you're looking for wonderful how-to, at least using enamels, there's nothing better than his DVDs out there. All right. I mean, Dave Parker and a bunch of others can tell you this. I think Andy's got a copy of the DVD. It's just wonderful. I watch it every time I'm going to paint, you know, 6 to 12 bodies. I watch it and I get ready. I mean, it really psychs me up. It energizes me and it just gives me that extra boost of confidence to be able to use the airbrush and get some good painting done. You know, the other thing too is that last time you saw that blue body that I had painted, that at 41 Willis, you know, that I did for the clinic, well, I finally cleared it. And you know, I've been using enamel clear, using the Pache Age. You just have to clean it really well, make sure you don't have too many flakes or no flakes at all left in there. You know, but I've been putting a lot of bling into my paint job, so you don't have to stress out that much. And I was also telling Dave Parker, and I'll tell everybody, I've made a video about this. You can go out and get yourself this set. This is the most bling anybody's ever put out. This is a set of 32 colors by Jacquard. You can look for them in your craft store or your art supply store, or you could go to Dick Blick and get it through them. That's where I got mine. That's one of my favorite art supply places, and so I get my stuff from them. And you just put a little bit goes a long ways into your clear, and you can bling out your we'll start out with the this is a silver. I had always wanted a silver 41 Willis, and you know, and it's and there it is, you know, and it's got a lot of, if you know, you I don't think it shows on the video, but it's got a lot of bling on it. Then, since I had the silver, I thought, hey, I wouldn't mind having a gold. So there is the gold. I painted a gold, and believe it or not, I cleared this one and the blue one finally, and you know what? It does not need any sanding or buffing. It's all shining all the way around, and you know, no orange peel, nothing. So it's good to go. And of course, last but not least, here it is, the blue, that mysterious blue. There it is. Now it lightened up a little bit because I did add a mixture of turquoise pearl and a little bit of the transference, from dark to light blue, which the paint already had. And then I also add very fine micro pearls. So it lightened up. And again, I shot it, and no need for sanding and buffing. So after a while, you know, you'll get so good at putting down smooth coats that you'll realize that if anything, you might have a spot here or there that you'll have to sand and buff, but the paint jobs will be spectacular. All right, so. I hope you're all, you know, building, and keep feeding us your eye candy, and also go on over to www.oldmansmodels.com or Lone Wolf Painting, and check out Don Yo's DVDs. I've been approached by a few people over the last couple of months about painting models for them, or doing, you know, work for them, And I had to apologize because I don't build for other folks. I just build for myself. I paint for myself. What I build and paint, I keep. Don Yost, on the other hand, paints professionally. So if there's something in particular you want, contact him and he'll set you up. All right? Whether it's a body or a full model, you can work something out. So check him out and check out his DVDs and keep on building and keep having fun. All right, my friends, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory. Until next time, have fun. Remember, styrene is a two-way street. That's not how it goes. How does it go? Okay, I'm sure you'll let me know. Inspiration is a two-way street. I guess my ear is making half of my brain absent. All right, my friends. Bye-bye.